All right, yo, so I'm back with another one. And I've been gone for a long time now, so I figured we started off with the producer beginner series, right? So you need melody, drums, if you want to do loops, you need some tracks for that, right? So let's get this started. We're gonna do like the bus routing and all that and setting that up. So inside of Studio One, I have the Pro Edition. So you want to go to your Personas tab. You want to get you a couple sample ones. Hold Alt to drag and copy these down. So you got your 808, your kick, your snare, snare two, hi-hat one, hi-hat two, clap, perk, and an open hi-hat. Nine percussion elements. You can see we can color these. Go 808, kick, hi-hat. Actually, no, snare first. Snare, ski. Let's get a clap because you know everybody loves a clap in their beat nowadays. Get a hi-hat. Hi-hat too. Perk. Open hi-hat. You only need the last one. I don't know, I added too many. So then what I like to do is I like to grab all these and pack it in a folder. Label it drums. Color code that whole thing purple. Now, instruments, your bands. So since we're gonna keep it all stock, let's go throw a presence in there. Actually, we're gonna throw like three presences in there. Actually, two presences. And let's see. What's another basic? Oh, the initial audio sector. That's kind of basic. Trying to refrain from like my big plug-in bass toys. Air, expand. Most people got expand. So, sector and expand to like your romplers, like your nexuses or whatever, and presences or your actual like synths. So, let's see, I'll go ahead and pack those up. Call this synths. And so what you want to do is you want to start routing these. So you want all these, add bus for selected channels, go drum bus, these, add bus for select channels, band bus. Now that you got that set up, right? Now you want to, oh, you can also add you like, let's see, two audio tracks, call them samples, sample tracks. So just in case you want to throw a loop in there, like two of them. Throw those in there. Then route these into the band bus. Now that you got those buses set up, now you want to get your hall plate and ping pong and echo setup. So you want to add effects channels. And also, after we add those effects channels, we're going to talk about gain staging. So see on this first one, we're going to get the hall reverb and go ahead and add your filter bus, which is where everything's gonna feed into. Oh, all these are gonna feed into the band bus. And these two feed into the filter. All right, let's get this set up. So you want to add a reverb. So keep it bass, keep it stock. Go to room reverb. Concert hall. Now this is going to be your plate reverb. Your ping pong delay. And your, what's that last one? The echo. So your plate is technically like your drum reverb, or yeah, we're gonna do this to drum reverb. So go back to room reverb. I usually like to use the snare drum bright. It's like a snare reverb. And let's see, get you a ping pong delay. Delay. Beat delay. You got these different ping pongs. Do an eighth ping pong. And instead of eighth note. So that's a pretty straightforward preset for that. Then on the echo, just want to get you a 1/4 delay. So we're going to turn 1/4. 50%. That'll work for that. And now that you got all those together, you want to come over here, get your wrench, and you want input control. So you want a gain stage. Gain staging is everything, because that's basically like your pre-mix. So you want to pull everything down to about 10.6. That's for everything. Even your instruments. And then you want to send your filter bus into the mix bus, and then the mix bus is going to feed into the filter, and the filter bypass going to feed into the mix bus. So let's see, filter bypass. And mix bus, which is gonna feed into your main. You never want to put anything directly onto your main. Always keep that in mind. All right, so now you got that set up. So you can add some things onto your mix bus. So like effects and whatnot. So let's add an umpire, which is basically like a guitar rig in a sense, and then add a reverb, add a EQ. And actually, instead of the room reverb, I'm gonna use the open air, which is impulse reverb. So it's like reverbs recorded in actual rooms. So that's pretty cool. We'll talk about that later. I'll show you a cool effect with that. And something else, that if you actually want to do these as sends, like if you know you're going to be constantly using those and you want to do them as sends, kind of like this. So when you put it on here, you can control the send level of it. That also creates more sauce, because then you have the dry wet signal. So what we can do is add another effect channel. Say you want to put umpire on there. Well, you get the gist. Like, you can put your effects on there and do it the same, but I usually just do it this way. And if I want to do it the other way, I do it on the fly. So for trap, your tempo is gonna be anywhere from 140 to 150 or higher. We can just leave it at 140. And so that is going to be your basic template setup. So you got your drums, couple synths, and you got some sample tracks. So next video we'll talk about drums, and then from there we'll talk about melody and filtering and all that. So this is Matthias. Thanks for tuning in.